हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी कंटिन्यू फर्दर अवर डिस्कशन ऑन एफोरिज्म्स. सो हियर इज द एफोरिज्म नंबर 215 विच डिस्क्राइब्स मेडिसिनल एग्रवेशन. ऑब्जर्वेंट प्रैक्टिशनर मीन्स फिजिशियन हु इन्वेस्टिगेट्स द स्टेट ऑफ डिसीज एंड इवन इन द urgent cases within few hours he will come to know that he has made a bad selection of remedy and patient is worsening. Occurrence of new symptoms to his own sufferings means the medicinal aggravation. So physician has made a wrong prescription which is responsible for addition of new symptoms in the patient's totality. Physician should remedy his mistake means physician should correct his mistake and he will select the most appropriate homeopathic remedy suitable for the existing disease. So here in this aphorism the physician has observed that in the follow-up, patient shows appearance of new symptoms and they can be correlated with the remedy administered. This indicates that physician has made a mistake and wrong remedy is prescribed, which starts proving on the patient and new symptoms appear. This is called as medicinal aggravation. So he should readily remedy this mistake means he should correct his mistake. How to correct this mistake? Stop this wrong remedy. If the symptoms don't disappear readily, you can antidote this and give the new remedy. Aphorism number 251 describes the alternating action. Dr. Hahnemann has written the remedies like Ignatia, Bryonia, Rostock show alternating action. All of you know that it's a primary action we have seen in drug proving. So these remedies show alternating actions. During proving, the power of altering man's state of health is the alternating action. During prescribing, if no improvement occurs, give a fresh and equally small dose of the same medicine. In acute disease, give within hours. So you repeat the dose of the same medicine. In the footnote, it is given that the reference that Dr. Hahnemann in the introduction of Ignatia in the first volume of Materia Medica Pura has noted that this gives alternating actions. So we go further. Aphorism number 252. The maintaining causes must be removed for effecting a cure. In the treatment of chronic diseases, the simillimum is prescribed and even after simillimum, antipsoriatic medicine, which is a deep-acting antimiasmatic remedy, is prescribed in the minute dose. If improvement is not seen, that means the cause is persistent. And this is a maintaining cause which is an obstacle to cure. There is some problem in the mode of life of patient. For example, we have seen this in the aphorism 77 as pseudo-chronic diseases. So in this case, if the patient continues to stay in the damp house, he may suffer from asthma which will not get cured. So this maintaining causes must be removed to effect the cure. So the maintaining cause must be removed to effect a permanent cure. So this is the maintaining cost must be removed for effecting a cure is described in the aphorism number 252. In the aphorism number 253 is described the signs of improvement. Who is noting the signs of improvement? Patient, and they are observed and confirmed by physician. In acute disease, the commencement of amelioration starts, and this commencement of amelioration seen first in the state of mind and whole general state. Degree of comfort, increased calmness and freedom of mind and high spirits. That means the physician, the patient feels fresh and energetic. It means he is returning to his original natural state. So what are the signs of improvement? Patient starts feeling comfortable. He starts feeling calmness. So patient might have become irritable, restless, and now he feels calm. There is a freedom of mind and he is in the high spirits. This means that patient is returning to natural state. If he is getting aggravation, then he feels constrained, pitiable state of the disposition of mind and body. And gestures, postures and actions are also noted by the patient, and they are describing that patient is in the state of aggravation. Physician should perceive this in close observation. So the physician should perceive the signs of improvement. The signs of improvement and the minute dose is described in the 253 aphorism. So see the footnote. The signs of improvement in the disposition of mind and body soon after similimum and minute dose. So our homeopathic remedy is a similimum given in minute dose. Large dose of even homeopathic medicine causes long lasting disturbance of mind and body. Converted homeopaths and others have prejudices. They fail to understand the salutary effects. Salutary means the harmless effects of smallest dose of lowest dilutions of homeopathic medicine. So the signs of improvement occur first in the disposition, general disposition of mind and body. And then it is because the similimum is prescribed in minute dose. What happens if large doses are given? They are hazardous. They produce side effects. And even the large dose of homeopathic medicine causes long-lasting disturbance of mind and body. Converted homeopaths and others have prejudices. They fail to understand the harmless effects of the smallest dose of lowest dilution of homeopathic medicines. So we go further. Aphorism number 254. So these states of the signs of improvement, the patient is feeling amelioration or aggravation. All these states, the physician will note these changes and don't rely on the patient. First, the most important is the observations of physician. So patient may narrate his the change in the symptoms, but they should be confirmed by the physician. aggravation of existing symptoms or amelioration of the symptoms is noted by the attentive observing and investigating physician. He will check and confirm. Sometimes patients are unwilling to tell about aggravation or amelioration. So at this time, the physician will go to the each small point, each small symptom told by patient, and he will note it down one by one. So the physician will note the change and not the patient, because sometimes patients don't tell correctly about aggravation or amelioration. So physician will go step by step with each symptom and then will ask the patient how he feels with this each and every symptom. So we end here today's discussion. Thank you.